गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ज्ञानमंजरी विद्यापीठ डिजिटल प्लेटफॉर्म। आई एम मनीष कलोलकर एंड आई एम गोइंग टू टेक योर इकोनॉमिक्स लेक्चर। बिफोर इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन, मीनिंग एंड इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ डायग्राम्स एंड ग्राफ। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी अबाउट एस्पेक्ट टू बी कंसिडर्ड व्हाइल ड्रॉइंग डायग्राम एंड ग्राफ, एज वेल एज वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ग्राफ। फर्स्ट वी विल सी एस्पेक्ट टू बी कंसिडर्ड व्हाइल ड्रॉइंग डायग्राम और ग्राफ। व्हाइल मेकिंग ग्राफ द फॉलोइंग एस्पेक्ट मस्ट बी कंसिडर्ड। फर्स्ट पॉइंट, द चॉइस ऑफ टाइप्स ऑफ डायग्राम और ग्राफ एंड देयर प्रेजेंटेशन। द राइट टाइप ऑफ डायग्राम और ग्राफ मस्ट बी चूजन टू मेक ए पिक्चर मोर इफेक्टिव। सर्टेन डेटा कैन बी प्रेजेंटेड इन अ डायग्राम, बार डायग्राम एज वेल एज इन अ पाई डायग्राम। द यूजर मस्ट मेक द राइट चॉइस टू मेक द पिक्चर मोर इफेक्टिव। सी, देयर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डायग्राम, मेनली बार डायग्राम, पाई डायग्राम, पिक्चर डायग्राम, स्कैटर लाइन, सर्कल। देयर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मेनी डायग्राम। फ्रॉम दिस डायग्राम विच डायग्राम और ग्राफ वी वॉन्ट टू यूज, दैट वी हैज टू डिसाइड दैट विच विल इफेक्ट मोर टू पब्लिक और मोर टू द रिलेटेड पर्सन। दैट इवन वी कैन से फर्दर दैट विच इज इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड, लाइक दैट सच डायग्राम शुड बी वी शुड हैव टू चूज। देन फ्रॉम दैट वी कैन मेक इजीली और इवन वी कैन इजीली मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड टू अदर्स एज वेल एज वी कैन इजीली अंडरस्टैंड ऑल्सो एंड मेक अंडरस्टैंड अदर। सो हियर मेन पॉइंट ऑफ वी कैन से फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज विच टाइप ऑफ डायग्राम वी हैज टू चूज, विच मेनली बार, पाई एक्सेट्रा। सेम वे क्लैरिटी, अ पिक्चर मस्ट लुक नीट एंड क्लियर। डिफरेंट कलर्स और शेड मे बी यूज टू डिनोट द वेरियस कॉम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ अ पिक्चर। सी, देर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डायग्राम and from which one he has to choose, he has to decide. Same way here written clarity, so it should be neat and clear. In simple words, diagram should be neat and clear, as well as in Gujarati what we are saying, gobru no jo kharab no jo. Even our government also has taken a stand about we swachh bharat, even not we should be not swachh in our we can say surrounding, but in our work also we should be clear and neat. Neat should be there. Same way diagram should be such that it should be easy to understand, it should be clear as well as neat and proper information should be there. It should be not that much difficult, or even it should be not that much hard and too difficult to under. And even further they say that it should make use of different colors or shade that it affects directly to the people. See, if there we can say pie diagram is there, in pie diagram there are circle type of diagram will come. In circle different parts are made, in that parts different color we can use, from different parts or different color parts different color we will use. And from that we can say this color represents this point and again point. Detail about that diagram we will discuss in that point. But here we will say that color should be used for different shapes, should be properly used. Scales and measures. See, scales are the main component for the diagram. See, to make a picture look appropriate in size, scale must be taken in accordance with the data. See, we will directly draw that with the hand or without scale. If we will draw that a straight line will be not drawn. But if the scale is there, that proper straight line for the x-axis and y-axis we can easily draw. And with that our graph will look good as well as proper and neat and clear. In this, see, straight line is not there, but with the help of scale, we can make straight line and as well as it looks more attractive. So this such component should be also required. Scale your measurements instrument should also be there. So we can easily understand. Next point, representation of axis. Both axis of a diagram or graph must be denoted or represented with appropriate details of what they present. See, in graph we can both in on x-axis and y-axis. See, in both x-axis and y-axis, different proper information should be given. So proper information, if it is given, then we can easily understand it, and details should be properly but in short. See, in detail we cannot write them. In short and neat, we have to write there. Third, next point, data table and source of data. See, diagram and graph must be accomplished by the data table from which they are created, and by mentioning the source of data, the pictures become more reliable and authentic. In last lecture, I have shown table of price per unit, demand, as well as profit per unit. See, that was a table. From that table, we make a diagram. In diagram, we have not for directly make that, but proper table should be made. From that table, we can easily understand how a diagram is made. See, all details cannot be written on graph and diagram. In it, we have to write short and sweet. So, table is necessary. So, in table, we can write detail, and from there, we can easily understand graph. Clear? Next point, method of calculating the data. When the picture is not drawn from self-exemplary data, but is drawn from the data supplement with the statistical formula, it is appropriate to the statistical method briefly. See, here it is not, they are talking about graph. See, graph are, we have talked before that graph are for who? Not only for self, but for others related to the that topic, or related persons, we can say. So, proper equations are also needed. Even we can say proper statistical information should be known, and even proper information should also be given to the same. Clear? So, proper equations are needed. We need to calculate the details given in the diagram. Clear? So we will discuss 6 points of aspects. Now we will go to types of diagram. In type of diagram, there are different type of diagram. Mainly picture diagram, scatter diagram, line diagram, circle diagram, bar diagram, and pie diagram. See, these are some type of diagram. From this, which we want, or which is more essential for us, or which we can easily make understand to the people whom we want to make understand, that diagram we have to select. From that, we will select different type of diagram. But here we have to learn. So we will take first point, time-based line diagram. In this time-based line diagram, this type of diagram we have to make. You can see on a board. See, we will see here, first of all, picture which is shown the shape or slope of a relationship in economics between two variables are often drawn. For example, a demand curve, a supply curve, etc. See, here in line diagram, it depends on line. We can say it depends on growth and decrease. We can say expansion or contraction, increase or decrease of demand or supply. As per a businessman, we will talk. See, commerce is a business related department or subject. We can say commerce is totally related to business. So in we are talking here subject economics, but we are a student of commerce. So we, everything before also, many times I have told you that any point, whether any subject, economics, OC, account, states, any subject we will discuss or we will study, as for a commerce student and as for a businessman. In our minds, by studying any of these four subjects, we have to study as a businessman. See, if we will study as a businessman, then we will with theoretical knowledge, we can also think as a practical. Commerce is a thing in which both sides he has to keep common, theory as well as practical. By work, we will do theory work, but in our mind, we have to learn as a practical also. If any points here we are discussing, then we have to discuss. See, here it is said about a demand curve or a supply curve. In this demand curve and supply curve, we have seen before in 11th standard also. See, in 11th standard, in demand chapter, we have seen that when a price decreases, demand of the product increases. Price decreases, demand also increases. Both have opposite relation. Both doesn't have same relation. Same way, if price increases, demand decreases. So in that we have seen in the diagram also, in even our exam also, about demand question also was there. Increase and decrease of demand question also was there in a 11th standard exam, in which diagram we had drawn in a graph paper, and where we have seen how price increase and decrease. This type of diagram also had been asked in that exam. If you had done that, you will be remembering. So, same way, if here we will talk about demand curve. So, if demand curve it goes up, then we will say that demand of the similar or that product has increased. There are many aspects of increase in demand. Mainly, we can say that when price decreases, demand increases. The main point of increasing in demand is a price decrease of a unit. Per unit product price decreases, unit increases. See, before many times we have talked about onion in our lecture. Yes or no? When at that time in 11th standard, see, in that time when we have talked about onion in 11th standard, at that time I have told per 20 kilos, price of the onion was nearby 2000 rupees, 1500 rupees. Was there too, from 1500 to 2000 rupees. Why that much price was there? Because supply was less. At that time, supply was less, but and demand was same. Demand was steady. Demand was steady, but the supply was less. Same way. Now, what the position is today? What the position? Here, position is that supply has increased. At that time, before 4 to 6 months ago, the price of onion was at a peak point, at a high point was there. But today what happened? The supply, at that time supply was low, so less supply was there compared to demand. Demand was there for we can say 10 quintal, and the supply was there only nearby 1 quintal or 2 quintal. But here what happened? Now demand is constant. Demand today, before 6 months and today, demand is constant. 10 quintal means 10 quintal. Because the onion, we can say customers has limited, or we can say consumption of onion is same from that day to today. Both are same. But what is different here? Different is here that farmer has produced bulk amount of onion. So demand of the onion is now also 10 quintal. Before 6 months also it was 10 quintal. Or there may be little bit different. From 10 quintal it can be increased to 11, or it can decrease to 9. But nearby minor changes will be there. But the main difference is what here? Here price. Price has decreased to per 20 kilo nearby 6200 rupees. Yeah, 120 rupees. Per 20 kilos. See, at that time before 4 months or 6 months, per 20 kilo, what was the price rate? Price rate was nearby 1500 to 2000 rupees per 20 kilos. And here, what is there different here? Price of one beer today is nearby 60 to 120 rupees, you can say, or per 20 kg. See, clearly understand. Now, today and that day, only difference is what there? There are mainly two differences. One difference is supply and second difference is price. But demand is same to same. See, there is no difference in the demand before 6 months of 1 year and today. But the main difference is price and supply. But price and supply is also not positive relation. Both as negative relation. How? We can say here, when there was less supply, price increased. See, in many other factors, many, we can say, international products, price is made or determined, we can say price is decided by the businessman. But here, for we can say consumer products, we can directly use by consumer, that product's price, here we can say it is different. They cannot decide, farmer cannot decide the price of their product. But it is given to APMC, and in APMC, how much supply is there? See, demand there is no change. I am talking about supply. At that time, supply was nearly 2 quintal, 1 quintal or 3 quintal as well. But now here, supply has increased. Supply has increased nearby how much? Demand is of 10 quintal, but supply has increased to 30 or more than 30 quintal. See, it is just an example. It is not perfect. See, we have taken this example only for understanding. Supply has increased, but demand has same to same. Demand has not decreased. Demand has not decreased. Demand is same to same, but the supply has increased. So, supply has increased, what it will happen? Price automatically decreases. If supply is less than demand, then price will increase. But supply is more than demand, then price will decrease. So, here, onions today's price, we can say it is very less. It is not even affordable to farmers. But that we have to not discuss. It is affordable or not affordable. But here what we have to discuss, that demand is constant, but supply was less. When supply was less, demand was constant, then price was high. Same way, when today demand is constant, but the supply has increased. From here to increase to here, then what happened? Supply increased more than demand. And what had happened? Then price has increased. So, same way, here we will understand based with the help of a diagram. We will take another example. See, but first we will discuss the independent variable is measured on x-axis and the dependent variable is measured on y-axis. See, here y-axis, this is y-axis. These we can say as a dependent. Everyone would be knowing about dependent and what is independent. Independent what? They doesn't affect. There doesn't affect any factor. While here, dependent variables are affected by many variables. On y-axis, see, this is y-axis. On this y-axis is called as a dependent variable. While x-axis, this is x-axis. This is x-axis. This is an independent variable. So, further we will talk. Economics often use line diagram representing time-based self-explanatory traits of a variable. For example, size of different time periods, rate of inflation in various years, literacy rate in various years, etc. Such diagrams can be termed as time-based diagram. See, this we are talking about time-based diagram. Our topic is time-based diagram. In time-based diagram, we have which type of diagrams are included? Then here it is written as size of population of time of different time period. See, here we can discuss. See, in this table, here different time period is given and increase in population. But this is different time period. In this different time period, we can discuss about size of population, inflation rate also can be described in this. So in literacy rate, in this type of diagram, like this diagrams, we can discuss different or types of topic like size of population of different time period, rate of inflation rate, literacy rate can be discussed in this type of diagram. We will take such one example. See, in this example, you can see in your textbook and also board, here table is given. In table, in 1951-61, what was the percentage of growth rate? See, in last year, I'll give one example of our one student. She was a scholar of our class. I have asked a question, what was the, in further there is in economics, population topic will come, or new chapter will be. Then in that I have discussed one, I have asked one year, in exam one question, what was the growth rate of population in India in 1971-81. See, what I have told at that time, that what was the growth rate, R-A-T-E rate, percentage here is given, same way, percentage are both are same. So what was the growth rate of a population in India in 1970-81. Here what is written? Growth rate was 24.66. If we will consider that at that time there was, what was what? It is just an example. We will discuss that there was 100 crore people were there in India in 1971. There was population of 100 crore. Now, what was the growth rate? We should write 20.6%. Yeah, if we will convert it into number, then it will happen 24.66 crores. We will here discuss about total population increase of rate, we will say then 24%. But if we will discuss about total population, then it will write, then also it will be nearby 24.6 crore. But what that girl, she was a scholar. See, I am not talking about student, but scholar. What she wrote, total she wrote 124%. See what she wrote, 124%. She also notified that percentage also. What means here, 124% means, if at that time population is 100 crore, then she wrote 124%. 124% means what will be the population in 1981. See, in starting 1971, the population was 100 crore, for example. She wrote 124%. What I have heard, if 124%, what will be? 100 crore plus again 124% means we can say 124 crores, and total population at the end of 1981, what was the population? The population would be, as per her, what would be the population? Then she knew her total population at the starting of 1981, as per her, the population was nearby 224 crore population will be there. See, we can say this is very easy. See, here table is given, 1951-61, the percentage rate, same way, 1981-1983-2001-2011-70.6 growth rate. But very exam, and we are not having much time, we are having less time. Time to time, as per our, if we will not waste time and we will write continuously, then our paper will finish in time. So in hurry up, what she made mistake? She made mistake of year. She had given barrier from 24 to 124 person. Well, then if 124 person will be there, many people, she is not talking about one such example, many people may mixing each other from what is growth rate. See, difference between growth rate and total population, they both mix up. See, if today I will ask what is the growth rate, what is the growth rate of 19 between 2001 to 2011 is 17.64%. But they doesn't make difference between growth rate. Then if I give question here, then sir, what is this? It is easy. It is easy, I know. But minor mistake can change your total answer. See here, if I ask about growth rate, then the answer should be 17.64 crore. Instead of that, if we will at that time, we will know nearby population was of 105 crore. Then you will write that 105 crore, then answer would be wrong. So you should never mix up between population growth rate and population. Over now in the future chapters, there will be population chapter only will be there of population. So in that we have to consider what is population and what is population rate. Both are different. So we have to make clear about it and not, we should not mix up both. So here now we will take an example. Example number 1.4. Present a percentage growth rate of India's population since 1951. See, in 1951-61, after independence. This table is about after independence. After independence, 1951-61. See, total growth rate of percentage. Here, sign is given, percentage. Percentage, it was 21.64 between 1951 to 61 percentage increase. See, percentage it is given, not increase in total. In this between the year, total population has not increased to 20 crore. See, don't mix up that. Once again, I am repeating, it is about percentage. See, here at that time, we can take example that the population was nearby 50 crore. See, 50 crore population, for example. In 1951, population was 50 crore. Here, it is given nearby 20, increasing in between 10 years, 51 to 61, increasing in population rate is 21%. 21.64, we can say 21%. Then what we have to consider? See, in this 20%, we have to directly measure that, 21%, so we make total, so it will be 71. No, it is wrong. But this you have to clearly understand. See, it is about percentage. So what will be the percentage of 21? Percentage of 21 of 50 crore will be, 50 will be nearby 10 crore, we will say. Nearby 10 crore. So increase in the population as per 51 if 50 crore population at that time was there, then there will be difference between 51 to 61. 51 to 61 total population increase as per 21% increase in population rate will be 10 crores. So clear, same way in 1951 to 61 there was rapid increase. See here, we can see this table as well as diagram. See, in diagram, there in 1951 to 61 growth rate. See, in this diagram, we can say from 1951 to 61, there was first there was increase in percentage. It is increase in percentage of population, not increase in population. So, from first, we can say in 1951 to 61, there was increase in percentage growth rate of 21.64 crores, which increased to 24.8 in between 61 to 71. See, 24.8% has increased between 61 to 71. Sir, then next decade the increase in population growth rate was 24.66. There was a minor difference between these. There was only 0.14% change had occurred in decrease in population growth rate. See, decrease in population growth rate, not decrease in population. I am repeating once again. It has decreased. Again, we will see in 1981, it again decreased to 23.8 or 87, nearby 1% decrease from 1971 to 81. It decreased to 23.87% decrease in population growth rate. Further, in 1991-2001, it decreased to 21.54% growth rate. Again, in 2001-2011, it decreased to 17.64% growth rate of a population. See, in first period, we can say there was in first decade a rapid growth. See, from there was nearby difference of 2-3%, nearby 3%, more than 3% was there, but in this 3% difference was there. From second decade, there was different nearby 1.4. In second decade, there was minor difference, decrease in growth rate. In third percent, there was nearby 1%. In fourth decade, there were, we can say, between 1981-91 to 1991-2001, there was decrease in nearby more than 2%. And in last decade, see, between 1991-2001-2011, there was rapid decrease in percentage growth rate to 21.54 to 17.64, means nearby 4%, nearby 4% decrease in growth rate. See, population is growing, population hasn't decreased, but the, we can say, increase in decreasing rate. Population is increasing, but at a decreasing growth rate from 1971 to 2011, is at a decreasing rate. Clear, everyone? Ready? This we have discussed about time-based line diagram. In next lecture, we will discuss about another type of diagram, which is bar diagram. Simple bar diagram we will discuss in next lecture. Clear? Thank you. Jai Hind.